students enter university holding self-made and instilled religious views. Here at the University of Technology, several individuals have changed their ideologies, which has resulted in a more diversified philosophical community. With these philosophical changes, persons who were strongly associated with religions break ties and hold to ideologies that do not subject them to just a belief. At the University of Technology, this is a highly infectious trend, and students are most susceptible.
Well, before UTech, I spent my previous 7 years at a boarding school in St. Elizabeth by the name of Monroe College. I was exposed to a lot of different cultures on the island, coming from dorm mates, coming from Westmoreland, Montego Bay, all different parishes, right back all 14.
Students such as Peter Campbell are captivated by the university experience, and their conflicts are confirmed, reaffirmed, or dismissed.
I was a choir boy in first form coming up to third form. When I was about 11, 10 years old, my father had bought a Junior Gang CD. I think it was Halfway Tree. That was my real experience to Rastafari, right? My lifestyle has changed a lot compared to before I started to see myself in another light. I started to stop, well, for one, I stopped going to parties.
Despite Peter Campbell not engaging in the party lifestyle, there are different events which Rastas partake in. One such event is Dubwise, held at Tiki Hut on Old Hope Road.
My name is Sherry, and I go to UTech. The reason why I'm here is that usually I come to Dubwise, and it just gives me this kind of vibe that it's like a serene vibe. It doesn't matter what kind of day you're having, you come here and you just feel at home.
I stopped eating meat for quite some time, but then I saw that it was supplemental. It was very necessary for my diet. Also, not only did I stop eating meat, but I started to partake on more of a vegetable diet. I started to eat less rice, I started to eat more yam, more potatoes, more grown provision. My main dishes are things like stew, without the stew, callaloo, veggie chunks. I love veggie chunks. I've tried it in many different ways.
I and I as Rasta, we have to try preserve ourselves from sick by eating a real good and perfect. Try eat right. Keep up the blood, for the blood are the most important things. You see me? Now if people eat for belly full, they would have eat some meat and some beef and say them belly full. But if you really check your history and check even the Bible, and say don't make your body become a living sepulchre. That means you must try for sure yourself. Yes. Anything you put in inside and eat you bring out. Yes, so if you continue like say eating meat for the rest of your life, you find out the spirit just keeps straying at all times, believe me.
Really?
Yeah. So as I say, eat right.
Eat
and
right.
Drink right.
The information that the church gave to me, that's what guided myself from a younger age, because that's the type of family that I grew in. I am not. I guess that is where my conflict would come in. Because I'm not a person who believes that a religion is the truth. I believe that a religion is more true than another.
That's my kind of guy. I'm Rasta when I gotta be Rasta. Not gotta be, when I want to be, or if I'm doing a Rastafarian expression. If I'm with Muslims and it's important to be stressing the Muslimic elements of God and religion, I use that. Christianity when I have to do Judaism. I do consider myself to be Jewish, though, in my history. I do feel that. I love Hinduism, so I clearly will be Hindu when I need to be Hindu. And Buddhist and the yin-yang expresses my very philosophy, the dialectical nature of the world and God. That's the kind of thinker I like.
I know myself to an extent, but there is so much to know. The more I know myself, the more I know what I don't know myself.
The source, if there's a common source, if there's a common ground between the two religions, more generally, one would assume that the Bible would be used because the two religions appeal to Bible.
Peter Campbell is influenced by the teachings of Christianity and Rastafari. He has failed to resolve his conflicts, and as such, he neither defines himself as Christian nor Rastafarian.